Yeah, God bless you tonight. This is the marvelous light of God. My name is Pastor Geraldine. Welcome once again. I appreciate all of you tonight that have been watching the program every week, Tuesday and Thursday. May the Lord bless you mightily. Tonight, I want to pray. May the Lord Almighty God open your understanding tonight and give you wisdom, give you insight in His word. I pray tonight that the Lord will bless all of you that have been watching this program and all of you that are about to watch it more and more. May God bless you mightily. May God increase you. May God prosper you. Every power that has been disturbing your business, your life, your marriage, may the Lord dismantle them in Jesus' name. I pray that this December, the Lord Almighty is going to supply your needs. You will not do this Christmas empty-handed. This Christmas, the Lord is going to do Christmas for you. The Lord will celebrate you this Christmas in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that whatever that you want to see your end in this December, you will see their end in the name of Jesus. Any power that doesn't want you to see 2019, that power will not see 2019 in Jesus' name. The Lord who have allowed you to see the month of November will give you opportunity to see the month of December. The same God will give you power to see the month of 2019. From January to December in Jesus' name. I pray that you, the Lord Almighty, is going to supply your desire. As you are listening to this word of God tonight, the desires of your heart shall be met. In Jesus' name we pray. Cover your ear and your eye and heart with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. The topic tonight is said, search yourself. The topic tonight is said, search yourself. That's what the Bible said. Search yourself. The topic tonight, search yourself. Now listen. The Bible said, let's go to the word of God. Let's start from there. Because the Bible said, without him we can do nothing. The book of Ezekiel chapter 8. The book of Ezekiel chapter 8 from verse 5. Then said he unto me, son of man, lift up thy eyes now to the way towards the north. So I lifted up my eyes the way towards the north, and behold, the north world at the gate of the altar, this image of jealousy in the entry. But what am I saying? Ezekiel has been calling upon the living God, was calling upon the living God, praying and asking God. Say, Father God, we have been praying, we have been fasting. We have been doing night vigil, doing fasting, reading Bible, hearing, watching Christian channels, doing sowing seed in the church, doing all manner type of things to see that they will please you. Upon that, Lord, what is holding their miracles? What is holding their blessings? What is holding their promotion? What is holding their testimonies? What is holding their upliftment? What is holding their documents? What is holding their signs and wonders? Father God, God, Ezekiel. He said, I want you to call the members of the church, call the Christians as a whole, ask them to search yourself. And that's what I'm telling you tonight as you are watching this message, search yourself. The Bible said to Ezekiel, ask the members of the church to search themselves. You have prayed, you have prophesied, you have did everything. Upon that, no tata for nyanya, nothing to show. Things are not happening as you suppose. But Ezekiel called upon the living God, and God said, come my son, come let me show you. You should ask these people to search themselves. That's why I said, search yourself. Ezekiel chapter 8 from verse 6. He said furthermore unto me, son of man, seest thou what they do? Even the greater abomination that the house of Israel committed here. Can't you see abomination they committed here? In the spiritual realm, in the supernatural. Now let me show you that I should go far out from my sanctuary, but turn thee yet again, and thou shalt see greater abominations. See, let me explain to you something. God was showing Ezekiel what the people of the Lord have been doing. They said they go to church, and they said they worship God, and they said they serve God. Upon that, they are doing things, all manner type of jejemeje around. And God said, the Bible said, in the book of the Ezekiel, chapter 8, from verse 2, Now listen. Then I behold and know a likeness as the appearance of a fire. From the appearance of his life, even that downward fire, and from his life, even to upwards, as the appearance of the brightness, as the color of the amber. Verse 3. And he put forth the form of an hand, took me up from my head, and the Spirit lifted me up towards the earth, between the earth and the heaven, and brought me in a vision of God to Jerusalem, to the door of the inner gate that looked towards the north, where was the seat of the image of the jealousy, which he provoked to jealousy. God called Ezekiel. He said, come, let me show you. The people you are praying to, the people you prophesy to, the people you are calling, you are going fasting and pray every day. You people you are doing night vision to. You do night vision for these people. You do fasting for these people. You pray for these people. Come in the supernatural. He put hand here and carry Ezekiel. Say, come. Let me show you what they are doing in the altar of images. And people will come to the church. And then we went back to their houses. And they will be doing certain ejejemages. Doing certain things. They will be doing certain things. Some critical things. And what they are doing was hindering prayers. What they are doing, delaying prophecies. What they are doing, delaying sources. What they are doing, delaying promotions. What they are doing, delaying signs and wonders. And Ezekiel keep on asking God the question. God, what is delaying the progress? You promised me that whatever I declare shall come to pass. And God said, my son, all your prayers have been answered. But there is something that hinders prayers. I cannot tolerate these images around. So many people have some image in his house. They have some images, some rings, certain properties in their home. I cannot tolerate it. Either they trust me or they trust that thing. They cannot serve two masters at a time. So if you are not getting what you are desiring from God, search yourself. And God called Ezekiel and showed Ezekiel what is going on in the spiritual realm. What these people are doing secretly are coming up to him in the spiritual realm. He called Ezekiel and said, come and see your members. And Ezekiel now stood up and looked at and saw all the members of the church. He said, go down and ask them, search yourself. Now from verse 7. And he brought me to the door of the court. And when I looked, behold, a hole in the wall. There was a hole in the wall. In the house of God, there was a hole in the wall. And he said unto me, go in, behold. And he asked him, what I did, there was a hole in the wall. Verse 9, he said unto me, go in, behold the wicked abomination that they do here. So members of the church, they move in the spiritual realm, in the house of God in the spiritual realm. They go there and dig hole. And the dream meeting, that there will be no prayer, will not be answered in the church. There will be no testimony. There will be no breakthrough. There will be no success. There will be no promotion. There will be no signs and wonders. There will be no child bearing. And God will call Ezekiel. He said, come and see what they are doing inside the wall. The church where you serve God. Come and see what they are doing inside those walls. Inside. Then verse 10. So I went in and I saw. Behold, every form of crippling things, abominable beast, all the idols of the house of Israel portrayed upon the wall round about. And that's the reason why the Bible says, don't curse a king in your own chamber, and don't curse a rich man. At least something that have wings will carry your voice. Because inside the wall, there are things that have wings. The Bible says, all manner type of the beast, they are inside the wall. Verse 11. And there stood before them 70 men of the ancient of the house of Israel. In the midst of them stood Jezaniah, the son of Sapphira, with every man his incense in his hand, and they took a cloud of incense went up. If you read the Bible from book of Isaiah chapter 1 from verse 11 down, the Bible said incense is an abomination to the Lord. And when you do that incense, the Lord will hide his eye, the Lord will hide his face from you. He will not pay attention to your prayer. And that's why these people will hide inside the wall and be burning incense. And they say they are members of the church. Their spirit went out to go inside the wall, doing meeting. And they are there, but something inside them with witches and wizards. They will go inside the world, burning incense and candles. And because of that, you are in the church to fasting and praying, and the prayer refuses to be answered. Check it out. Make sure that you don't leave this place. Hear what I'm telling you tonight. From verse 12. Then he said unto me, Son of man, hast thou seen what the ancient of the house of Israel do in the dark? Every man in the chamber of his imagination. For they say, the Lord see us not. The Lord have forsaken the earth. Because I hide my face because of those incense. And they are saying that I never noticed them. Now listen, verse 13. He said also unto me, turn yet again, and thou shalt see greater abomination that they do here. Verse 14. Then he brought me to the door of the gate of the Lord's house, the same house of God, and which was towards the north. Behold, there sat women weeping for Thomas. There are some people that when the church will be going on, their duty is to just bend down and think they are just interceding. Their Bible said it is only spirit of familiar spirit that whisper. They will just go there, bend down, cry. This Bible said, come and see. Can you just see what is going on here? Can you see what is going on here? There are some certain things that are bent down. You think that they are meditating, they are knocking hand on the floor. There's something inside them said that there will be no answer to prayer. Pray anywhere you can get answer. Now let's go to verse 15. Then he said unto me, have thou seen this, O son of man? Turn thee yet again. Thou shalt see greater abomination than this. Now, this I'm talking about house of God. Now verse 16. He brought me into the inner court of the Lord's house. Behold, at the door of the temple of the Lord, between the porch and the altar. What is between the porch and the altar? From where the pastor stay, from the altar of God, and from the altar of God to where the seat of congregation stopped. So between the altar and the congregation. Between the altar and the congregation. So between that place where people used to answer altar call, where they used to do dedication, where they used to dance. The Bible says from between that place, that's what the Bible is talking about now. He said, have thou seen this, O son of man? He said, between the porch and the altar, where about 25 men with their back towards the temple of God and their faces towards the east, they worship with the sun towards the east, that nothing good will happen in this church. Nothing good will happen in that church. They keep on interceding, block the prayer the man of God has been releasing. Man of God will say that it shall be well with you. You will prosper. You will make it. You will increase. You will advance. But the people block that prayer and diverted it to the east. That's the reason why the Bible says, have you seen this? Now verse 17. Then he said unto me, have thou seen this, O son of man? Is it a lighting to the house of Judah that they commit abominations, quit the committee here? For they have filled the land with violence, have returned to provoke me to anger. Lord, they have put a bridge to their nose. Which means, what people are doing in the church hinders prayers. What certain people come to the church to do, they hinder prayers. That's why the Bible says, hypocrites, they cannot enter. They will not allow that people to enter. They cannot collect. They will not allow that people to collect. That's what the Bible called them, hypocrites. The idea to crucify pastors. The idea to crucify members. The idea to crucify and criticize churches. Criticize activities of the church. What Muslims are doing, nobody criticizes it. What occulted people are doing, nobody criticizes it. Church people, what people are doing, nobody, they will focus the church of God. This is an attack. Search yourself. And when you come to the same church, you want God to bless you. He that criticizes the church of God is criticizing God. And when you come to the church, God will fight from you. And you say that we should go to the church, where is your God? Until you humble yourself and seek his face. Turn away from your wicked ways. Search yourself. Can you see what is going on in the church? And Ezekiel called upon them. He said, you people should repent. You people should change. All of you should change from your evil ways. Because vision delay prophecy delays because of the also meditation the people are doing, carrying all kinds of image around, putting all kinds of judgment and sacrifice everywhere, thinking that those things will save them. That's why the Bible says in the book of Ezekiel chapter 12, tell them therefore, thou said the Lord God, from verse 23, I will make this proverb to cease. They shall no more use it as a proverb in Israel. But say unto them, the days are at hand, the effect of every vision. So many visions that was hung as a result of images. If you hear this word of God today, and you decided to put away all your images, decided to put away all the sacrifice and the candle and incense you are burning, all the vision that was provided for you, all the visions you have received from the men of God, the Lord have to activate it. The Bible said the days are coming. That days will come only when you change. For there shall no more any vain vision, nor flattering divinations within the house of Israel. For I am the Lord, I will speak, and the word that I shall speak shall come to pass. I shall no more be prolonged, for in your days. And God said, oh, rebellious house, people who doesn't want anybody to control them because of the legitimacy they have in their pocket. And when I say the word, I will perform it, says the Lord. Again, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, son of man, behold, they of the house of Israel, the vision that he said is for many days to come. He prophesied of the things that are far off. Therefore say unto them, thus said the Lord God, there shall no more of my word be prolonged anymore, but the word which I have spoken shall be done, says the Lord. Only when you do this, when you search yourself and drop all extra foreign gods you have, you drop all the strength gods you have, and every prophecy, whatever you prophesied, whatever people prophesied before you, you will see it into reality. In Jesus' name. Now let's go further. The book of Lamentation, chapter 3, from verse 37. The Bible says, now let me start from verse 35. Lamentation 3 from verse 35. To turn aside the right of a man before the face of the Most High, the Lord cannot approve it. You are all right, God cannot turn it aside. Anybody who wants to turn it, you say no. Because as long as you serve him, as long as you don't follow another God, and to subvert a man his own cause, the Lord approved it not. Verse 37. Who is he that is saved, and it cometh to pass when the Lord commanded it not? If God discover that you have images around you, God discovered that you serve another God, God discovered that you visit idols, you visit native daughter shrine, you visit some occultic places, and the Bible said, and people prophesy unto their life that by this time next year, this type of thing will happen. Bible said, who is he that is said it come to pass when I did not command it? So, what they are telling you will not happen except you have made your ways. That's why I said, search yourself. You'll be complaining that I sow a seed, I make a sacrifice, I give offering, I build a house, I do this for the Lord. Upon that, things are not happening. Why? Bible says this is a sacrifice of a fool. Verse 38. Out of the mouth of the Most High proceeded not the evil and the good. But every evil and the good come from the mouth of the Most High God. Verse 39. Wherefore does a living man complain to a man for the punishment of his sins? If things are not happening to you, the blessings, the miracle you are looking for, don't complain to anybody. It is God who allows you to be in that form. Only when you make a U-turn and return to the Lord, and the Lord is going to bless you back. Now verse 40, Lamentation 3:40. Let us search yourself. Let us search and try our ways and turn again to the Lord, and let us lift up our hearts with our hands unto the God of heaven. And we have transgressed and have rebelled, have not been pardoned. thou hast covered with the anger and persecuted us. Thou hast slain, thou hast not pity. Now verse 44. Thou hast covered thyself with a cloud that our prayer should not pass through. Why? It's because you worship idol. You follow other gods. Search yourself. There are many people who are always looking at people. He said you worship idol. What they are doing is not good. What they are doing is not good. Search yourself first. Examine yourself first. You have to try yourself first. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 6. The book of Luke chapter 6. From verse 39. Luke 6:39. He speaks a parable unto them. Can a blind lead a blind? Shall they both fall into the pit? The disciple is not above his master, but everyone that is perfect shall be as his master. Verse 40. Why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but perceivest not that the beam that is in thy own eyes? You are looking at somebody, telling somebody, amend their ways. But in your own eye, you have a lot of beam, a pillar that is around the house. But you want to remove sawdust. Are you hearing me? The Bible says, either how can thou say to thy brother, let me pull out thy mote that is in thy own eye, when thou thyself beholdest not the beam that is in thy own eye? Thou hypocrite, can thou first the beam that out of thy eyes? Then thou shalt see clear to pull out the mote that is in thy own brother's eye. For a good tree bringeth forth, a good tree bringeth not forth corrupt tree fruit, neither doth a corrupt tree bringeth forth a good fruit. For every tree is known by his own fruit. For of a thorn men do not gather fig, for out of the bramble bush gather the grapes. A good man out of a good treasure of his heart bringeth forth a which is good. An evil man out of the evil treasures of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For out of the abundance of the man's heart, a man speaketh. What am I saying? Search yourself, brother. When you search yourself, you'll be able to know the reason why your prayer is being hindered. You have to turn to the Lord. The Bible says, in the book of 2 Chronicles, the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, from verse 13. If I shut up heaven that there shall be no rain, or if I command the local to devour the land, or if I set the pestilence among my people, then you search yourself. If my people which I call by my name shall humble themselves, when you discover attack, problem happening to you, you humble yourself. I pray and seek the face of the Lord. Turn from your wicked ways. Then he will hear from heaven and forgive your sins. Why did I say you should search yourself? Search yourself in a way that when things are happening to you, don't blame anybody. You have to return back to the Lord. Don't blame your mother, don't blame your father, don't blame brothers, don't blame sister, don't blame uncle, don't blame cousins. Don't blame anybody. You have to return to the Lord. The Bible says, out of the mouth of the Most High God proceeded the good and the evil. It is God who maketh all of them. Isaiah 45 said, he created the evil and he created the good. So he make two of them. So what am I saying tonight? I want you to go home and search yourself. Examine your ways. Try your ways. And return to the Lord. The Bible says you have not been forgiven. So when things are not happening, all you need to do is return to God. And when you return to the Lord, the situation will change to better. When you return to God, things will turn around for good. When you return to God, things will be able to move ahead again. The Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 2 verse 5, remember where you are fallen and return to the Lord. Otherwise, they will put off your candle. So you have to return to the Lord. If my people which are called shall humble themselves. So if you make a U-turn, the Lord is going to answer you. Now let me give you something again before I close. Let's see the book of 1 Kings. The book of 1 Kings chapter 21. The book of 1 Kings chapter 21 from verse 20. And I have said unto Elijah, hast thou found me, O my enemy? And he answered, I have found thee, because thou hast sold thyself to walk evil in the sight of the Lord. Behold, I will bring evil upon thee, I will take away thy prosperity, and I will cut off from Ahab he that passed against the wall, and he that is shut up and left in Israel. Verse 22, I will make thy house like the house of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, like the house of Baasha, the son of Azah, for the provocation wherewith thou hast provoked me to anger, and made Israel to sin. Now he was releasing cost, promising Ahab, he's going to take away whatever belonged to him. Now verse 27, and it came to pass, when Ahab had those words, that he rent his cloth, and put sackcloth upon his flesh, and fasted, and laid sackcloth, and wept softly. He talked to the Lord. He repented and asked God for forgiveness. He said to himself that yes, I committed sin. Yes, he did evil. Yes, what he did was wrong. Oh, he talked again to the Lord. And the word of the Lord came to Elijah the Tishbite and said, see how Ahab humbled himself before me. Because he humbled himself before me, I will not bring the evil in his days, but in his son's days will I bring the evil upon his house. God have never shown no to Elijah before. But because Ahab will examine himself, Ahab will search himself that what Elijah said was true. And Ahab will now make a U-turn and go into fasting and cry unto the Lord for forgiveness. And God now called Elijah and told Elijah that every evil and every good is the one who produces it. Anybody who says anything and the one who is going to produce it. He said, I'm not going to bring the evil you pronounce upon Ahab. I will suspend that evil until after Ahab enjoys his life finish. I will bring the evil upon his own children. What does that mean? You see, God is one who produces whatever anybody said. If people curse you, God will produce it. People say they're going to bless, God produce it. But you have to go to fasting and prayer and say, God, I'm sorry. And God will stop every curses that is on the way. He will now turn it and suspend it and allow you to be blessed. Allow you to enjoy your life. So tonight, I pray for you tonight. As you listen to this message and you examine yourself and talk from your wicked ways, you knew that right where you, wherever you are, and ask God for forgiveness. I declare tonight that every curse anybody has placed on you, as you are going to kneel down tonight after this message and pray unto God, those curses, God is going to suspend it in Jesus' name. Ancestral curses will be suspended. Generational curses will be suspended. Parental curses will be suspended. Any curse placed on you by your former girlfriend will be suspended. Any curse placed on you by your former boyfriend will be suspended. Any curse placed on you by any man or woman shall be suspended. Any curse placed on you negatively shall be suspended. Ancestral curse shall be suspended. Every curse you inherited shall be suspended. Every curse God bringing upon you and I because of your father, and you fast and pray, God will suspend it. In the name of Jesus. Therefore, every curse placed on you, prayerful curse issued on you by any man or woman tonight shall be suspended. Because you hear this message tonight, the Bible says freedom cometh by hearing, and deliverance cometh by hearing, and success cometh by hearing, and upliftment cometh by hearing. Hearing the word of God.